Hi mommies and daddies, welcome back to MomCom India. Is it okay for me to give cow milk to my baby less than 1 year of age? If no, why not? And if yes, what is the ideal age of introducing cow milk to my baby? Let's talk about all these confusions that we as parents have, because a lot of these confusions come from the society or our elders who tell us that they've given us cow milk right from our birth or right from the start, and it is easy, it is economical. So let's get into the video to understand the details.
To watch all the videos on this channel, click on the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to get regular updates from MomCom India. Let's become a big fat family soon.
So I have a baby who's 13 months old, and I've done immense amount of research on this topic by talking to my doctor, by going through various studies that have happened on this topic, because I also, like you only, wanted to understand that why is it that I can't give cow milk to my baby. My mother said that I should be doing that because that's what she did to me, and it's economical, it's so easily available, and I can just depend on it blindly. But is that right? So basis my research, what I found is that for babies less than 1 year of age, cow milk is a complete no. And there are multiple reasons why do they say that. Number one reason is that the nutrition that a human baby needs, that is not found in the right quantity in cow milk. So cow milk does not suffice the nutritional requirements of a human baby, because of which it creates a lot of problem if given before 1 year of age. Number two is that cow milk is very low in iron. Now we all know that around 6 months of age, the iron reserves of a baby's body start to go down, and that is the primary reason why that is a perfect time to introduce solids, because through solids what you try to do is bring back those iron reserves in the baby's body. If you introduce cow milk at that point of time, what you're doing is you're giving the baby something to fill the baby's hunger, fill the baby's stomach, that is not rich in something that the baby's body actually needs, which is iron, because of which a lot of babies have anemia, they have pale skin, they are irritable, poor weight gain, you know, a lot of problems start to happen which we cannot even anticipate, that could be because of something that should not be given to the baby. Number three is that cow milk is also low in vitamin C. We all know that vitamin C is the immunity booster for our body. So when we are giving a baby something that does not have vitamin C, there is no way that we can guarantee good immune health of our babies. Also, vitamin C and iron go hand in hand. So if you're not giving vitamin C to the baby, the body will not be able to absorb iron as well, because of which the immunity will be down, the blood requirement of the body will go down, and all of these problems will start to happen. The next reason is that cow milk has very complex proteins, and a baby's body, which till about 1 year is only developing its digestive system, is not ready to absorb those complex proteins. It puts a lot of pressure on their kidney and causes a lot of digestion issues, which could be as bad as blood in the stool. It could be constipation, it could be loose motions, it could be just gas, it could be tummy ache, it could be multiple things that could be arising because of the body not being able to digest something as complex as cow milk. The next reason is that cow milk is also known to cause obesity in children. And I say so because what happens is that if you've ever tasted breast milk or formula milk, it's on the sweeter side. But cow milk does not have a sweeter taste. Now, what parents normally do is they start mixing sugar in cow milk and then offer it to their babies less than 1 year of age, which is a disaster, because sugar should not be given to babies less than 1 year of age. So here you're giving two complex things to a baby. Baby, just to ensure that the baby is having something and his milk requirement is being met, which can be met through formula also. The next reason is freshness of cow milk. Is it really easy to get fresh cow milk? That's a question that you should ask yourself, because these days what's happening is that cow milk is being heavily diluted with water. We don't even know, and we can't even trust, you know, the source of cow milk, because of which children face a lot of tummy ache, digestion issues, and you know, all these issues with stool, again because of the complex dilution that has happened with the cow milk. So as per me, all these reasons are strong enough to tell us that even if you have to make an expense by giving formula milk to your baby as a supplement of breast milk in case you're not getting it, it's okay to do that till 1 year instead of giving your baby something which in a way is not meeting their nutritional requirement, especially below 1 year of age, is causing a lot of complexity in terms of digestion and may have health impact at a stage when you will not even know that it could be because of that. Now, a lot of babies, you know, a lot of mothers feel that I gave cow milk to my baby and he was able to digest it. That's very good. That's an excellent thing to do. But you don't know what's coming your way. So I think that let's go as per what science or what the medical association suggests. And that is that do not give cow milk to your baby less than 1 year of age because of strong reasons like these. Now, having said that, let's also talk about what happens after 1 year. My baby also turned 13 months and I'm making a transition to cow milk from formula milk now, and I can talk about some details around that also. Number one is that after 1 year, you should make a transition, but make very slow transition. It's okay to make a transition now because now from a digestion standpoint, your baby is absolutely ready to explore the world just like you. Your baby is having 3 meals in a day, your baby is having 2 snacks in a day, and your baby is okay to have milk or dairy products just like you would consume. Number two is that whatever deficiencies are there in the cow milk, that now can be met through the solids that you're giving to your baby. So the overall balance of nutrition is taking place now. That's why also so it is absolutely okay to give the cow milk now. Third is that when you're making this transition, always start slow and always ensure that you're giving full fat cow milk to your baby. That's so important for the growing up babies. Now, what I mean about slow transition is that if you're giving 5 milk feeds to your baby in a day, try replace 1 with cow milk and the remaining 4, let it be breast milk or let it be formula milk. This way, you will know that because of that 1 feed, how did your baby react? Did your baby have any stomach trouble or your baby was a happy baby? And you'll be able to gauge if the transition is happening smoothly. A lot of people do this mistake that just for their baby to be able to accept cow milk, what they do is they mix breast milk and cow milk, or they mix formula milk and cow milk, and I feel that that should not be done, because that way is what you're doing is that you would not be able to understand the real impact of the cow milk on your baby's body, because the mixing will never tell you that did it happen because of mixing, did it happen because of cow milk, or did it happen because of formula milk. So all of those combinations are very complicated to understand. Keep it simple. 1 feed in a day cow milk should be good enough to make the transition. The next thing to note is that for babies between 1 to 2 years of age, their daily dairy requirement is up to 20 ounces in a day. Dairy should not be given more than that quantity, because then it starts interfering with the iron absorption of the body. By dairy, I mean it could be milk, curd, cheese, cottage cheese, basically any form of dairy that you're giving to your baby. So what you need to do is step back and analyze that during the day, have I given up to 20 ounces of dairy to my baby? If yes, then you should stop there, because anything more than that is going to cause harm than benefit to your baby. One more question that we are usually asked is that, is it okay to mix health drinks with milk after a baby turns 1, like Bonvita, Complan, Pediasure, and you know, all of these. So as per my doctor, it's not okay to do that, you know, before 2 years of age. And when you do that, also always read what does the brand say, because normally each brand says that what brand is suitable for what age group of the baby. Before 2 years of age, what you could do is you could mix sugar, you could mix dates, you could mix dry fruits, you could do these combination instead of moving on to a health drink that's not suitable for babies less than 2 years of age. So with that, we've come to the end of this video. This was my view on why you should not introduce cow milk to a baby less than 1 year and how you should introduce for a baby after 1 year. So with that said, in case you have more questions, feel free to post them below. Click on the like button if you did like the video. Do subscribe to the channel by hitting on the red button below and clicking the bell icon so you get timely notifications of our video. Please share it with as many friends as you can, because this is a myth that has been going on since ages. I don't think there was a lot of awareness of why cow milk should not be given back in our times, because of which it was fair for our parents or our caretakers to do what they did. But now, since there's a lot of awareness, since there are a lot of studies on this topic, I think we should be more aware and do the right things rather than just giving into them. So with that said, we will see you soon. Please follow us on Instagram and Facebook by searching Momcom India, because there's a different world of Momcom India that you will see on our social platforms. Thank you for talking to us. We'll see you soon. Bye.